God bless you. Welcome to Truth in Brief. And our question today is, how shall they hear without a preacher? How shall they hear without a preacher? We've been looking at the questions of Scripture. And like I said, there are about 3,300 questions in the entire Bible. And the more you look at these questions, the more you understand, you know, the latitude and the depth of God's heart revealed in the answers that we find in Scripture. The question for today is found in Romans chapter 10 from verses 14 and then even verse 15, the first part. So it says, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? How will they be calling on somebody in whom they have not believed? Now, here is the background in verse 12. In fact, verse 11 of the same Romans chapter 10, the Bible says, for the scripture says, whosoever believes on him will not be put to shame. In verse 12, it said, for there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich to all who call upon him. In other words, God can save, God can bless, God can help anybody who calls on him. Whether the person is Jew or Gentile, wherever the person is, rich or poor, high or low, God is available to help and to save. He now says in verse 13, for whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Anyone that calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. No matter how bad, no matter how sinful, no matter black, white, red or brown, green or purple, if there are human beings of that color, if they will call upon the name of the Lord, they will be saved. Now the Bible now asks a question. It says, but how will they call on somebody on whom they have not believed? So you see, it's impossible to call on somebody you have not believed. Then he asks another question. He said, and how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? How can people believe somebody they've not heard? And how can they call on somebody they have not believed? Then he asks an even more fundamental question. He says, and how shall they hear without a preacher? This is why it is so important to preach the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. How will they hear without a preacher? How will the world hear of the love of Jesus except somebody tells them of what Christ has done for them? One man of God said, the gospel is only good news if it gets there on time. It's only good news if it gets there on time. Reinhard Bonnke, that great evangelist, Bonnke said, an unpreached gospel is no gospel. If people don't hear that there is a savior, if people don't hear, look at the world around here, a world of 7.8 billion people. And in this world where we are now, it's only 33% that is Christian. And that automatically means that if you take away 33%, 67%, almost 70% of the people in the world today, if Jesus were to come today, they are lost forever. According to the Bible, because there is no other name given among men under heaven by which we must be saved. They need the gospel, and Jesus paid for them. Even among the 33% we are talking about, it includes everybody that calls the name Jesus and is called Christian, whatever church, whatever cult that takes the Bible as their book. So even the 33%, they are not saved. Only about 1 billion people in the world today are evangelical Christians. That means they are born again. They have received Jesus as their Lord and their Savior. The rest of this world that you see, look at Asia. Look at, you know, Southeast Asia. Look at the Middle East. Look at all of these places. How will they hear without a preacher? How will they hear? How will they hear of the love of Jesus? And this is the terminal generation. The world is coming to an end. It is manifest. Look at all the things that are happening. How will our world hear of this glorious Savior without a preacher? Now, look what it now says in verse 15. He says, and how shall they preach unless they are sent? So the question now is, have they not been sent? So he says, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings. So have we not been sent? Listen, all of us believers, we have a responsibility to preach the gospel. He said, but I'm not a preacher. Me too, I'm not a preacher. I'm a medical doctor by training. But I preach the gospel because people need to hear of the love of Jesus. They need to hear the only message that can save their souls. How will they preach? Are they going to preach from the church pulpit? Not necessarily. Everybody is a preacher, but everybody will not preach from a church pulpit. Maybe you are a doctor. You can preach from the hospital. Maybe you're a businessman or you're a teacher. You can preach to your students. You can preach the gospel in the marketplace. I call it marketplace ministry. And we have a whole training on that. Every believer is called to preach the good news of the Savior that saved you. You can tell your story. You don't need a certificate in theology to tell somebody what Jesus has done in your life. How will they hear without a preacher? The world is in need of carriers of this good news. If you cannot preach like, you know, evangelist Billy Graham or Rabbi Zacharias, you can talk to children. You can speak to market women. You can talk to your classmates. You can bring the good news to your students. You can bring the good news to your parents, patients, or to your family members. But people need to hear. People need to hear. And then you can preach with your money. You can give to missionaries. You can give to ministries. We can help you. You can either give to our own ministry or we can channel the money. We can connect you with missions organizations that are reaching people in the bush, in villages, so that they can hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. But by all means, preach. Preach with your life. Preach with your mouth. Preach on social media. Preach from your marketplace platform so that the world can hear the good news of the Savior that loved them and gave his life for them on the cross. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that, Father, you will make us ministers of this glorious gospel. That through us, people will miss hellfire. Through us, people will get saved. Through the gospel that we bring, people will find light and hope and forgiveness and mercy through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Don't forget that you don't need a big theological degree or certificate to tell other people what Christ has done in your life. Just share the good news and watch how God will use the simple message that you share to change the lives of many. Bye-bye.